Hey guys, welcome to my video on imaging and test files. Hey, I heard you want to set your room up for listening. Listen, it can be really complicated, so if you put your email address in the link below, I'll send you a PDF with everything you need to know. What I want you to do is go to your listening position, and in addition to your ears, I'm going to need you to have an SPL meter, like this digital one from Radio Shack, this is preferred, or an app like Sound Level Analyzer Lite. Set those to C-weighted, slow response, and with those two tools, in conjunction with the links in the description, I'm going to help you accomplish four goals. One is correct imaging. That's going to allow you to have a nice centered image so you can appreciate what the production team intended you to hear, and it's also going to help you match what's on screen to what you're hearing. Goal two is to eliminate bass localization. You don't want to be able to close your eyes and know where your subwoofer is. Three is correct and even volume of your system. You'll be using filtered pink noise to individually set all of your speakers' levels. So this ensures that not only are your speakers playing at the correct volume, but they'll be all totally in the correct volume for your room. If your room is 2,500 to 5,000 foot cubed, you're gonna need a reference level of 76 decibels. If for some reason you have to pick a smaller room, you'll be using 74 decibels. You're using filtered noise because of the modal response to your room that will distort your readings. So by using filtered noise, you're avoiding that. Make sure you play these audio files at full volume in your player. You wanna adjust the volume of your speakers if your speakers have volume controls. If not, use the system control on your computer or your receiver. If you want to explore more about room levels or the Bobcats K system, there's more information in the Monitor Wizard link in the description. The fourth goal that you'll be accomplishing is identifying the correct location for your early reflection panels. By dialing in all your imaging now, it's the same thing as measuring twice and cutting once. If your imaging is off, then what you can do is slide one of the speakers towards you, and that'll pull the image toward that side. I've also found that having tilted speaker stands can also affect your imaging. At this point, you can either move to the next video, video 5, and measure your room with acoustic software to get a control value, or you can go to video 6 and begin installing acoustic treatment immediately. So I hope this video has been a lot of help. If so, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. So go to one of those two videos, whatever you want to do, and subscribe for more videos. Thanks.